you, Lord our God, lover of souls. You uphold us in life and sustain us in death. To you be glory and praise forever. For the darkness of this age is passing away, as Christ, the bright morning star, brings to his saints the light of life. As you give light to those in darkness who walk in the shadow of death, so remember in your kingdom that your faithful servants, that death may be for them the gate to life and to an ending fellowship with you, where with your saints you live and reign one in the perfect union of love, now and forever. Amen. As the Father cares for his children,
so does the Lord care for those who fear him.
For he himself knows whereof we are made.
He remembers that we are like us.
Our days are like the grass.
We flourish like the flower of the field.
When the wind goes over it, it is gone.
And his face shall know it no more.
The merciful goodness of the Lord endures forever on those who fear him, and his righteousness on children's children. We sing together hymn number 638, 638.
Thank you.
Heavenly Father, in your Son, Jesus Christ, you have given us a true faith and a sure hope. Strengthen this faith and hope in us all our days, that we may live as those who believe in the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, and the resurrection to eternal life. Through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Please sit for our first greeting. A reading from the Lamentations of Jeremiah. My soul is bereft of peace. I have forgotten what happiness is. So I say, gone is my glory, and all that I had hoped for from the Lord. The thought of my affliction and my homelessness is wormwood and gall. My soul continually thinks of it, and is bowed down within me. But this I call to mind, and therefore I have hope. The steadfast love of the Lord never ceases. His mercies never come to an end. They are new every morning. Great is your faithfulness. The Lord is my portion, says my soul. Therefore I will hope in him. The Lord is good to those who wait for him, to the soul that seeks him. It is good that one should wait quietly for the salvation of the Lord, for the Lord will not reject forever. Although he causes grief, he will have compassion according to the abundance of his steadfast love, for he does not willingly afflict or grieve anyone. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Remain seated now as the choir sings a version of the 23rd Psalm.
Thank you. from John chapter 6, verse 37 to 40. Everything that the Father gives me will come to me, and anyone who comes to me, I will never drive away. For I have come down from heaven not to do my own will, but the will of him who sent me. And this is the will of him who sent me, that I should lose nothing of all that he has given me, but raise it up on the last day. This is indeed the will of my Father, that all who see the Son and believe in him may have eternal life, and I will raise them up on the last day. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
May the words that I speak be in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Why are we here tonight? Why are we here tonight? Well, the answer actually is very simple. We are all here tonight because of love. We are here to remember before God our departed loved ones, because we love them. In this life we received love from them, and we love them in return. And that loving does not finish or die with the grave. If it did, there'd be no point in us being here tonight. Your presence is proof of the fact that the reality of love continues beyond death into eternity. But what does that tell us about the teaching of the Christian faith regarding death? It tells us that this love must have come from somewhere. It isn't just a mental state of well-being. No. If we love, then our love has to have come from somewhere. And the Christian faith says it comes from God. This is what the gospel reading tonight, I think, is talking about. The Father's gift of love to us is eternal life. Have you ever read The Secret Garden? I love the part where as spring comes, the garden bursts into new life. So the young Colin gets off his sick bed and regains the use of both his legs. Something fills him with new life. We read, at that moment, something rushed all through him, a sort of rapturous belief and realization, and it had been so strong that he could not help calling out, I shall live forever. I know I will live forever. But how does what we're doing here tonight relate to that? Well, just as we can pray for someone in this life, we can continue to pray for them in the life to come. When we pray, it's not really to do with us asking God to answer our prayers, or indeed with even speaking words at all. It's rather simply being with God, with others on our hearts. Being with God and holding those we love before him. We don't stop loving someone, holding them in our hearts before God, simply because they have passed from this life. So when we pray for someone, we are linked to them through a bond of love that can transcend the grave. And this special love binds us together. But of course, we still grieve for the people we love who are no more physically with us in this life. We are sad that we will no longer have a chance to share experiences with them. Tonight, we have heard the choir sing Psalm 23, a psalm often related to grief. When I lost my brother, I remember reading this psalm, and I returned to Psalm 23 again a couple of weeks ago when I lost my dad. I clung to these verses, trying to find hope. I needed this psalm to find courage. The psalm begins, "The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want, but I achingly wanted more time." Those who grieve want more of everything. We want more of everything. We want more. We want more hug. We want more. One more laugh together. One more giggle. One more photograph. One more chance to say, "I love you." One more time to put things right. The psalm continues. "He makes me lay down in green pastures. He leads me beside still waters." When a person you love dies, life tends to lose all its colour. My waters was the opposite of still. They were raging with fury and pain. They were not still waters. We continue, "Even though I walk through the darkest valley, I will fear no evil, for you are with me." Now here was the glimmer of hope that I was searching for, found in those words, "For you are with me." Life is full of pain. Sometimes it feels like all the peaks are missing and that we are endlessly trudging through thick mud. But for the Christian, green pastures and dark valleys are both a part of life. There are times when God's abundant outward blessings are obvious, and we respond in joy and gratitude. But on other occasions, we're surrounded by loss and pain and darkness. Sometimes the path to the future is filled with fearful uncertainties. The way just seems long, with no end in sight. But we have hope. We have hope. Psalm 23 reminds us of this hope. The same shepherd who cares for us in the green pasture also remains by our side in the dismal valley and leads us through. We can count on his comfort and protection throughout life's journey until we safely reach our Father's house. Today's gospel, today's reading, this evening's reading, gives us even further hope. Jesus says, "I will raise you up on the last day." So our hope does not end with our dying breath. We have every hope to believe that our loved one will be raised with us. This means tonight we can pray for all those who have gone before us to our Father's house, for all those we love who have died. Yes, we still believe. Of course we do. We still believe. But if we turn to our all-loving Creator God in these times of loss, we will be given the blessing to get through our pain. So we give you thanks, Heavenly Father, on this special day for all the beloved souls that we remember tonight. Amen.
Now stand to sing hymn number 249, Great is Thy Faithfulness.
Thank you.
the end of each section, I shall say, Lord, hear us. And you reply, Lord, graciously hear us. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Almighty God, you have knit your chosen people together in one communion, in the mystical body of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Give to your whole church, in heaven and on earth, your light and your peace. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Grant that all who have been baptized into Christ's death and resurrection may die to sin and rise to newness of life, that through the grave and gate of death we may pass with him to our joyful resurrection. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Grant to us who are still on our pilgrimage and who walk as yet by faith, that your Holy Spirit may lead us in holiness and righteousness all our days. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Grant to your faithful people pardon and peace, that we may be cleansed from all our sins and serve you with a quiet mind. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Grant to all who mourn a sure confidence in your loving care, that, casting all their sorrow on you, they may know the consolation of your love. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
May we have strength to meet the days ahead in the joyful expectation of eternal life with those we love. Lord, hear us.
Lord,
help us, we pray, in the midst of things we cannot understand, to believe and trust in the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, and the resurrection to life everlasting. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Grant us grace to entrust to those whom we remember to your never-failing love, which sustained them in this life. Enfold them in the arms of your mercy, and remember them according to the favour you bear for your people. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We bring all our prayers together in the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. Now we come to the commemoration. Glory and honour and power are yours by right, O Lord our God. For you For by your blood, you are branches of the God, a kingdom of priests from every race and language, from every people and nation. So, we remember before God. Rita Wright, Frank Pierce, Joy Pierce, Ellis Scarborough, Madge Scarborough, Ruth Zoffinger, Friedrich Zoffinger, Harold Unsworth, Elsie Unsworth, Doris Gorman, George Gorman, Winifred Gorman, Robert Alton, Roy Jackson, James Stevenson, Jean Stevenson, Doug Thomas, David Norton, Gordon Williamson, Mark Norton, Sally Norton, Arthur Ball, Dora Ball, Jeff Delamere, Brian Martin, Edna Ellis, Ted Ellis, Donald Watson, Emily Watson, Philip Hiscock, Vi Hiscock, Roger Jago, Dorothy Grattan, Liam Grattan, Steve Grattan, Ella May Lucher, Ernest Petrich, Alice Petrich, George Somerton, Annie Somerton, Beryl Miles, Tom Miles, Bert Somerton, Donald Somerton, Edith Mills, Aileen Chapman, Alistair Turnbull, Bill Thorpe, Sydney Palmer, Gary Rhodes, George Rhodes, Albert Wood, Fred Carlin, Elsie Carl, Norm Evans, Florence Evans, Leslie Evans, Rex Henry Martin, Derek Welch, priest, John McNeil, Sarah McNeil, Susan Jones, Stuart Little, Kathleen March, Joan Seven, Peter Wardle, David White, Ethel Lang, Ian Robin, priest, Mary Connor, Bernard Connor, Carol Worthington, Jim Markle, Iola Burke, James Burke, Ryan Burnett, Alex Hart, Janet Piercini, Gemma Cox. This is a will of him that sent me, that I should lose nothing of all that he has given me, and I will raise them up at the last day. Lord God, Creator of all, you have made us creatures of this earth, but have also promised us a share in life eternal. According to your promises, may all who have died with the priests of Christ share with your saints in the joy of heaven, where there is neither sorrow nor pain, but life everlasting. Hallelujah. Amen. Now, I invite you to come and take candles there, and if you bring them over to the Easter candle, the sign of resurrection, I'll light them from the Easter candle, or give you a light from the Easter candle. If you would allow the choir to move first, immediately after we've lit the first candle. And while they're lighting their candles, we shall say the words of the Nunc Dimittis, which is printed on your sheet. And then as we light our candles, they will sing a hymn.
Lord, now let us grant thy servant to depart in peace, according to thy word. For mine eyes have seen my salvation.
which thou hast prepared before the foundation of all the living, to be a light to the life of the Gentiles, and to be the glory of thy people Israel. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. World without end. Amen.
Thank you.
say together, hear us, O merciful Father, as we remember in love those whom we have placed in your hand. Acknowledge, we pray, the sheep of your own fold, lambs of your own flock, sinners of your own redeeming, and fold them in the arms of your mercy, in the blessed rest of everlasting peace, and in the glorious company of the saints in light. Amen. We're now going to stand and sing one of the great Easter hymns, reminding us that God has overcome death in Jesus' resurrection. Number 433, Love's Redeeming Work is Done.
Comfort and his peace,
his life and his joy in this world and the next. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon you and remain with you, now and always. Amen. Amen. Rest eternal, grand unto them, O Lord. Let light perpetual shine upon.